The Wings finish October with a 4-9 record, hoping to build momentum after their win over Edmonton. After a 5-1 loss against the New York Rangers, forward Jacob De La Rose is traded to St. Louis for former first-round pick Robbie Fabbri. Fabbri, the 21st selection in the 2014 draft, was also teammates with Tyler Bertuzzi on the Guelph Storm, where they were OHL champions together.
Runs up that right side, but it's picked off by Fabbri. He has Bertuzzi in front. Fabbri, the backhand, it was blocked by the defender, and they jam it home. Bertuzzi, a whack at it.
With their new weapon, the Red Wings readied themselves for a weekend of battles hosting the Boston Bruins and the Vegas Golden Knights.
I'm just going to come in and do what I know I can do, do what I can to help this team and help contribute right away. Well, there's definitely a lot of speed on this team and skill as well. They're a good group of young guys here that are all hungry and that all want to win and play hard. So, you know, I'll fit in good with that.
Going back to last year, we matched up well against them. You know, the biggest thing is, you know, containing their big line and their big players and their power play. So we have to stay disciplined. We have to move our feet. And you know, we do have to make it about us tonight. And when we do that, we're on the forecheck and we're playing in the O-zone and making it hard, like I said, against their big dogs.
You know, the way we played from start to finish, you know, the style that they played, it's a hard-working group, and you know, they work. You know, the bench is up and talking, and you know, it keeps everyone engaged in the game.
Here comes Dylan Larkin. Larkin going wide with it, circling the goal, wraparound shot. Yes, he scores.
Same result.
Here we go. Marchand and Hronek.
Hronek. I was just look at him and he just dropped his head, so that's what happened.
We have good play up, even with Marchand missing the.
Oh no.
Right from, what a stop by Bernier. On the leading scorer in the National Hockey League, goals and points, as the Boston Bruins are going to lose two in a row. The Red Wings win for the first time in 4-2 over Boston. Robbie Fabbri with two goals. Jonathan Bernier, big stops and two helpers. First goalie with two assists. Chance to shoot, he's tripped, he scores! 2-2! Madison Bowie!
Look at this.
Scores!
He just overpowered him.
If there is one current Red Wing with potential superstar written all over him, it's rugged right wing Anthony Mantha. At 6'5", 235 pounds, Mantha is the complete package. He's tough, with a nasty streak, and isn't shy about policing the ice. Combine his physical game with an off-the-chart skill set, where he's as comfortable setting his teammates up as he is scoring goals. Mantha is among Detroit's best players. Despite missing 28 games this season, the premier power forward currently sits with 16 goals and 22 assists for 38 points. It's not hard to imagine a healthy Mantha will quickly be regarded as one of the NHL's elite level talents. Winning twice at home, the team heads west to play all three California teams. The trip starts off with a bang, winning in overtime in Anaheim to kick off the trip.
Mantha Saved by Miller. Prima, they score! Dylan Larkin! 37 seconds left. Red Wings tie it up.
If you would have waited a second, you would have been caught.
Next stop, Los Angeles, where the season would take an ominous turn.
You know, it comes down to finding a way at the end there to, you know, 6-on-5 to, you know, eliminate that that rebound or that, you know, try to block it or somehow, you know, you got to find a way. But I thought overall it was pretty good. We picked up our game. I thought the second half was really good.
After a hard-fought 3-2 overtime loss to the Kings, the Red Wings would drop the next 11 games as losses and injuries start to take their toll on club performance.
You know, we leave this trip, we got 4 out of 6 points. It's certainly disappointing the way the LA game ended and the fact we had a chance to win tonight, but in the end, we got 4 out of 6 points.
The Red Wings will go winless in 11.
What do you need to do to win a hockey game? What does the team need to do to turn this around?
We need to fully put a full 60 minutes together. I mean, you've seen it too many times for us where we play good 40, 45, 50 minutes and there's 10 minutes there where we're, you know, just one part of our game isn't there. And for us to win in this league, we have to play all together for 60 minutes. And
proud of the way we work. Obviously disappointed in the score. You know, we just got to find a way to get some dirty goals and you know, it's coming.
After decades of decadence, this decade for the most part like New Year's Eve, looking ahead to a brighter future as we get set to ring in 2020, let's do so with hope rather than hindsight. And from a different view from where we started the decade at the Joe, beautiful spot here at Little Caesars, and it should be a festive atmosphere here tonight. Back here to Bowie.
Whoa, there you go. Again, who took him?
Listen again. Burns with a shot, partially blocked. Hronek for the empty net again.
Yes, indeed. Bingo.
We've been here for a long time. We know the passion of hockey in the city. Our fan base has been tremendous supporters. We know where we are in the standings. We know what our record is. I've been, you know, really thrilled with the enthusiasm of our fan base of watching the games, supporting the team, and you know, having a positive attitude and outlook for where we're at and what we're trying to do. So I'm very appreciative of it. I'm hoping everybody can remain patient as we kind of go through this process, because it's going to take, as I've said, and I'm going to say it again, it's going to take some time.
Now with a long feed onside, now it's Larkin breaking in. He shoots, he scores! That's his 100th career goal. He fires it upstairs, beating Sergei Bobrovsky, and the Red Wings are on the move.
With the first half of the season in the book, the team would begin its All-Star and bye week. Forward Tyler Bertuzzi represents the club in St. Louis. Tyler competed well against his peers, finishing 5th in the shooting accuracy and helped Team Atlantic to a second place finish, losing in the championship game 5-4 to Team Pacific. The lone Red Wings star held his own with the NHL's best.
Skills competition, and then twice you make the All-Star game, so this isn't as practice as you would think it is.
I was thinking about Tyler Bertuzzi. He's way too far from the net. He's usually in a lot tighter than that.
He thought he's hit that
last bottom right one about three times. He had to look back and make sure he got it.
You got the time to beat. Only two have gone, and Heischer's coming up. You feel like you put a little pressure on these guys now?
I think we're all kind of nervous, so anything can happen, but I think it's going to be broken for sure.
What's been the best part so far, and what are you looking forward to most in the next 24 hours here at All-Star Weekend?
Just hanging out with the guys, getting to meet new guys, and hanging out with everyone. And I think we're all looking forward to the 3-on-3 game tomorrow.
2-on-1 the other way. Anthony Duclair through the legs. What a goal. Tyler Bertuzzi. And a great feed from Anthony Duclair. And that's his first of the day.
Hard pass through. And it goes right off the skate of Bertuzzi. No kicking motion there, though.
Thanks for all the support, guys. I'm going for vacation for a few days, and we'll be back in the training right in the second half. Thanks for all the support, and we'll see you guys soon.